This week's Golden Apple Award winner is a proud South Carolina native. She says she spent childhood summers in a station wagon with her siblings.
Her dad gave them quizzes as they toured the state. I do that with my boys. And now she's doing the same thing with her students. News 4's Beth Brotherton introduces us.
I went to Italy again this past summer.
The photos in this classroom tell the tale of a world traveler.
And then this is a group where we went to Spain. And then I took a group to England and Ireland. So I try to travel with the students as well.
This St. Joseph's Catholic High School history and government teacher likes to tour the places in her textbooks.
Really, that's the Roman Forum in the background, and I just like showing them what else is out there.
And meet the lawmakers she lectures about.
It was a three-week learning experience and with other teachers from around the country, and we spent a week at Gettysburg and a week in D.C. and a week in Philadelphia.
Melby Carr is a history buff. She travels South Carolina during the summers, exploring Revolutionary and Civil War sites. It's something she did as a child and still enjoys today.
My dad, as we went through like Marion, would ask us questions about Francis Marion or something like that. And I was always reading those childhood biographies.
Students tell us her excitement rubs off on them.
When the teachers kind of not only like teach the subject, but kind of live the type of lifestyle where they could learn more about the subject and convey that to the kids, then it really makes a difference in the classroom.
What's significant about Romney winning?
Carr uses current events like the Iowa caucuses this week to help students understand history.
Ron Paul, he's making waves.
Her students are following the candidates on Twitter.
See, I don't tweet. I don't, so y'all know that. I don't tweet, whatever. But so y'all just tell me as they happen.
Some of them will volunteer at the polls during the South Carolina primary.
Did y'all see the graph that was on the news that said it was like 46% didn't make up their minds to just a few days beforehand?
Carr encourages her students to watch the news and do thorough research.
Sometimes they're more on top of it than I am. You know, they watch the news early in the morning or late at night or the Twitter, you know.
Advice to always keep learning, something she adheres to herself.
You have to continue to broaden what you know, because if you don't, the kids will catch up to you and pass you, so you have to keep learning.
A teacher staying current to keep history relevant.
The news and Twitter, I love it. Well, if you know a great teacher, nominate them for a Golden Apple Award. Forms are available at any Bilo grocery store.